Is there a head of for that region? Is there an office manager for each location? If there is, then that's the person you must engage with and convince to support what you're trying to do. This is vitally important if you are to be successful, because it is likely that they will have their own way of doing things. It's important to remember that every region is different, and this point is especially critical when the organization is spread internationally. Attitudes, experiences, and beliefs change from location to location. And if you're going to be successful, you need to appreciate this and respond appropriately. I was once asked to implement a business continuity management, BCM, program across a number of European countries and was given a relatively short time frame in which to do it. I had the necessary BCM knowledge, but how would I deliver this across 15 countries? The first step was to understand organizational structure at each location. Who were the heads of and what functions operated in these regions? I then examined how these regions had been operating. Were they successful? What issues were they having? Once I had a handle on this, I arranged one-to-one meetings with regional leaders via video or phone to understand them and their attitudes towards this discipline. I wanted to know what had gone on before and why they felt the BCM program had failed. I asked them what they would not like to see from me and how I could ensure success in their region. The answers differed greatly from region to region and enabled me to adapt my approach according to the information I had obtained. Furthermore, it meant that the head of the operation understood what I was trying to achieve on behalf of the organization and was far more supportive than they would have been previously.